I work in a healthcare and then I'm a manager and sometimes I need to let people go because of performance. It's happening every day. You know, we had a case here in the U.S. One FedEx employee actually went back to, you know, the office after being fired and then, you know, killed the, you know, the people there. So in this case, just want to ask you, how can do my job, you know, better about this? And then other than that, I really love my job, but that is very stressful situation.
예, 해고하고 청마제과 겁난다 이거죠.
So if you fire someone, there's the danger of them coming back and killing your part
return. Of it.
자기 역할이 해고하는 역할이라면 그 직장을 그만두든지 그 직장이 있으면 해고할 수밖에 없죠. 뭐.
So if your role as manager sometimes required to fire people, then you have two choices: either continue working at your job or quitting your job because you don't want to fire people.
Yeah, I thought you'd answer like that.
사람을 죽이기 싫다면 교도소 그 십자가에 못 박는 직업을 그만둬야 되죠.
So if you don't want to be involved in killing people, executing people, then you can't be a prison guard, for example.
그래서 우리가 생명을 해치기가 어렵다 하면 그 직업을 그만두고 딴 직업을 선택하면 돼요.
So if you don't like the impact that you're having by having to do this, then you have a choice to always change your jobs.
그리고 그래도 내가 직업을 거기 수익이 많거나 여러 가지 이유로 내가 그 직업을 가질 수밖에 없다면.
But if you know, so you want to stay on because of whatever reasons.
자기는 그 직책을 감당해내야 됩니다.
Then it's a responsibility and role that you have to be able to deal with.
그리고 그 결과에 대해서 책임을 져야 됩니다.
And also be responsible for what the consequences are.
남을 해고하는 직책이라면
because if it's a if it's your job to fire people,
분노를 살 가능성이 있고
then obviously there's always a risk for them being angry at you.
그래서 때로는 습격받을 수도 있죠.
Then sometimes maybe that might lead to attacks.
군인이 군대 가는 거나 똑같은 거예요.
In some ways it's like a person choosing to go to the army.
평화지 때는 뭐 월급도 받고 좋죠. 아무 일도 없고.
During peace times, you know, then it's a good job because you don't have to risk your life.
그러나 전쟁이 나면 죽을 위험도 있죠.
But if there's a war and you're sent to the front lines, there's a possibility of you dying.
그걸 선택하는 거예요.
So it's a choice you're making.
그래서 다른 길은 없어요.
So there's no other way.
두 번째 그 길을 선택했을 때
So second, once you made that choice.
위험들을 줄이는 방법은 있어요.
Then there are strategies you can put into place to lower the risk.
너 잘못했다고 그냥 자르는 거보다
So instead of firing somebody with a stern word.
내가 직책 이러니까
You know, try to explain that this is your role.
너를 이해한다.
Say that you understand the person.
미안하다.
But I'm sorry.
정말 이러고 싶지 않다.
This is not what I want to do.
그러나 나는 이 일을 해야 된다.
But this is something I have to do in my role.
네가 여기서 일해 가지고 먹고 살듯이.
It's just as you worked here as an employee to make a living.
나는 이 평가를 해서 이렇게 정리해서 먹고 살 수 있는 직책이다.
So part of my performance as a manager is to evaluate other people's performance and make a decision.
가슴 아픈 일이지만은.
So as a person, you know, it hurts you.
나는 이 회사에서 이 직책에 있기 때문에.
But because I fulfill this role in this organization.
이 일을 할 수밖에 없다.
I have no choice but to do this.
미안하다.
Sorry.
이렇게 하면 위험도가 떨어지죠.
Then, you know, with those words, you decrease the risk a little.
그래도 그 사람은 감정이 쌓이겠지만.
So obviously, that person will still be fired, still be angry.
너는 일 못하니까 나가라.
So it's better than, you know, kicking them out because they can't work.
훨씬 감정이 줄어들죠.
So, but you reduce that emotional hurt.
그러면 위험이 그만큼 줄어든다고 볼 수 있죠.
And also reduce the risk you face.
그래서 우리는 그들의 아픔을 이해는 하지만은.
So while understanding others people's pain.
그래서 미안한 줄은 알지만은.
And feel sorry about it.
그러나 내가 주어진 직책은 또 감당을 해내야 됩니다.
But at the same time, you should be able to do your job that you chose.
당신이 그 역할을 못하면.
But if you can't fulfill your role.
회사는 당신을 자를 거예요.
Because then the company will fire you.
그러니까 둘 중에 하나는 감당을 해야 됩니다.
So no matter what consequences you face because of your choice, you should be able to handle it.
그러니까 여기서 어떤 길이 좋냐가 아니라
So it's not a matter of which way is better.
그 선택에 따른 널 책임이 따른다는 거예요.
It's to realize that with every choice comes responsibility and consequences.
책임을 감당해야 합니다.
And you should be able to be, you should be aware of those before you make that choice.
첫 번째 질문자가 있었잖아요.
We had that first questioners before.
혼자 사니까 외로우니까.
And she's lonely because she was a single mom.
애를 뒀잖아요.
And then she had a mom, she had a kid.
근데 아기 생길 위험을 생각 안 했죠.
But she didn't quite risk the danger of her getting pregnant.
그러나 그런 일이 일어나잖아요.
But it did happen.
근데 그거에 대해서 책임이 지금 안 지려고 하니까 어렵잖아요.
But it's difficult. But if you try to avoid some of that responsibility, it becomes a source of suffering.
언제나 우리는 원인이 있으면 결과가 있다.
There's always a result based on a cause.
그래서 결과를 기꺼이 받아들여야 됩니다.
And if you provided that cause, you should be able to accept the result.
그 직책이 있는 한.
So as long as you're in that position.
비난받을 가능성이 높고.
There's a risk for you to be criticized.
미움 살 가능성이 높죠.
And there's a higher risk than normal for you to be hated.
그것이 싫으면.
But if you don't like it.
이 직책을 옮기고.
Either change your role.
그것이 뭐 이익이 많든지 하면
But if there are good other reasons to stay on
그 결과를 감당해내야 합니다.
They'd be prepared to handle the consequences.
여기 다른 길은 없어요.
There's no other way.
죄송합니다.
Sorry.